conflicts and the need to resolve them. We're going to discuss that with CNN contributor, former Obama White House ethics czar and fellow at the Brookings Institution, Ambassador Norman Eisen, and former White House ethics lawyer for President George W. Bush, Richard Painter. Gentlemen, good to see you united again in purpose and on New Day. Counselor Painter, while I have you, you were going at it with the social media director for Donald Trump a little bit this weekend. I want to get you on record about that. He was suggesting that they might primary a Republican who wasn't helping advance the president's agenda. You said that may violate the law. How so?
Well, you're not allowed to use your official position for influencing an election. That's illegal under the Hatch Act. And he has a so-called personal Twitter page that's loaded up with official photos of him in the White House and lots of White House stuff on there. That's not a personal Twitter page. That's official, and he's using that now to encourage someone to challenge a Republican congressman in a primary. That's political activity. That's illegal in an official capacity. He could do it in his personal capacity, but without mentioning his official title. This is an abuse of his office, and he would have been fired in the Bush administration if he'd done that. We would not have put up with that in the White House.
Guy's name is Dan Scavino. People can go online, see what he's been saying, judge for themselves. Thank you very much for that. Richard, all right, now we have the numbers we just heard from Christine, Norm. So he's got a lot of rich people in there. That may matter to some, may not to others. Why does it matter to you?
Good morning, Chris. It matters to me. Same reason it mattered to Professor Painter and the Bush White House. We made people unload their holdings, sell them, divest them, because of the conflicts that they create. If you take Jared and Ivanka, for example, they are hanging on to major holdings, real estate, trade-related, big financial debt to big banks. That means they're going to have to recuse in all those areas. And if they stumble over an issue, they work on an issue in one of those areas that they shouldn't. We're talking criminal liability. Why would the president put his son and his son-in-law and his daughter in harm's way? Why would they do that to themselves? They ought to divest.
Well, the other side of it is, to you, Richard, is look, you know who these people were when you elected Trump and his family, and they got a lot of money. There'd be a lot of hardship if they had to divest. People understood that they were wealthy. Many supported them because they were wealthy. So it is what it is. It's already baked in.
Well, yes, but they have to comply with the law, and it's a criminal statute. So what this means is Ivanka and Jared will have to recuse. They cannot participate in policy discussions in a broad range of areas, including bank deregulation and finance, because real estate is so dependent upon what happens in the banking sector. They're going to have to recuse from tax reform because there's so many goodies in the tax bill. For real estate, there are already goodies in the code for real estate, so they got to stay out of tax reform. And then finally, trade, because Ivanka is making clothes overseas, bringing them over here, and then slapping her name on them with a label. Everyone else is doing that, but that's a big trade issue. That's why jobs are going overseas. Well, now she and Jared are both going to have to recused from trade negotiations. And it's not just them. We have Wilbur Ross as a shipping company, the commerce secretary. So he may have to recuse from trade negotiations. I don't know if anyone's going to be left to deal with trade other than the president and Steve Bannon, and that could be a real disaster. So I'm very worried about this situation.
How do you police that, Norm? I mean, at least let's just limit it right now to the son-in-law, Jared Kushner. I mean, he has been pretty high profile in dealing with a lot of international components of the White House. China, we understand, is going to be a part of that. Trade, according to one of the informal advisors here on New Day this morning, is going to be a big part of the agenda. How does he not involve himself in that discussion if he's an advisor on China? And how do you police that?
Well, Chris, even in a normal White House, the policing issues would be complicated. Remember, all of Ivanka's conflicts are attributed under federal law to her spouse, Jared. So he's stuck with the fact that she has all these China entanglements, including trademarks, like her dad, trademarks in China that give China a lever over her. They can yank the trademarks if they don't like the Trump-China policy. In a normal White House, you'd have a compliance system. Richard and I both ran them. In the White House. But here the compliance system is broken. So when you already have actual or apparent violations by so many people around the president, Bannon, Priebus, Kellyanne Conway, Mr. Liddell, who it appears may have even violated criminal limitations. We need more information to know for sure. It doesn't seem like they care about ethics, and are they really going to tell the boss's son-in-law and daughter, hey, don't do that, or you've done wrong, or I'm going to report you to the Office of Government Ethics? I don't think so. It's a recipe for disaster.
Let me ask you something else while I have you. Richard Painter, Tom Price, Health and Human Services Secretary, was in the Congress, obviously, in the House of Representatives. There's an allegation that he may have made a sale transaction on a drug company right after creating legislation that was favorable to the regulation of that same industry and company. What's your take?
Well, I've worked on insider trading law for almost 30 years, and if you have somebody's buying the stock on the same day that their development's happening in Congress that are non-public information, a classic insider trading case. So I don't know why the SEC isn't looking into this. Maybe they are. But this is not the kind of thing that a member of Congress ought to be doing, moving in and out of stocks at the same time as they are working on bills that are going to affect the price of the stocks. There's insider trading issues as well as conflict of interest issues. I don't know how he got into that mess, but it's very, very troubling.
Well, we'll see if it develops into a mess. Like you said, the infraction is only as good as its enforcement. Let's